This evening, which is a text amendment, I believe, VA 2017-17, City of Valdosta.
Yes, sir. This is a text amendment to Chapter 218 of the Land Development Regulations of the City, called the LDR. It is to modify or add actually a subsection to the standards for mobile homes, which technically we refer to as manufactured housing. In your packet, I had a footnote, I passed out a revised version of that this evening, which added a small paragraph at the end, as well as staff's recommendation. Also included in that is an updated chart of comparison of these development standards amongst various cities in Georgia. But in your packet is the three definitions of the three different types of mobile homes. To summarize it, a Class A mobile home is a double wide that meets certain standards of pitch roof and masonry foundation and that type of thing. A Class D is a mobile home that does not meet that kind of standard. It's usually a single wide, but it can be a double wide that does not have all of those features. And then a Class C is one of the older style mobile homes that were built before 1976, before the federal law changed the manufacturing standards of those. It is very rare to see one of those still in existence. So generally, Class A and Class B are what we're dealing with. We've had some requests over the years, you may recall, where conditional use was requested for a mobile home to be located in an R6 zone neighborhood. Such a request has to meet the current standards, which means it has to be a double wide and have the pitched roof and so forth. However, before, about 10 years ago, it was not required to meet all of those standards. It was possible for someone to go through that same process of a public hearing and request approval for a single one. So we have a few of those still around in the city. What has motivated this was the notion to allow the possibility of an owner-occupied single-wide mobile home that's a legal, non-conforming use, to allow the owner to replace that single-wide with another single-wide. Under the current rules, we do not allow that. We consider both a non-conforming use and a non-conforming structure. So once the structure is removed, the only way to go back with that use is to put in a Class A mobile home, which means upgrading it to a double wide and so forth. In your packet is the comparison chart, which shows the other cities, as well as Lowndes County, and you have the Payara in the list. To see who allows double wides, who allows single wides, you see it is somewhat mixed. But most of these communities do not allow a new single wide at all, unless it's neither a mobile home park or an agricultural zoning, or in a couple cases in specific zones that allow that kind of use. In the far right column, this is what I had added since our last work session, but it's a column that's titled, does it allow replacement of a non-conforming single wide? So in other words, if these other communities have a single wide that was approved years ago, but through their own regulation changes, such as in Valdosta, would they allow a non-conforming single wide to be replaced with another single wide? And as you go down the column, most every community there does not allow that. Talking with the planners and the zoning professionals in these communities, it's pretty much the same thing you find here. They have very few of them. They consider them non-conforming structures, so just like any other non-conformity. Once the structure is gone, it's gone. So to replace it, you have to put in one that meets current standards. One thing I've noticed in that last paragraph on the staff report is a process that Valdosta has that some of these other communities do not. We have a PELUC process, P-E-L-U-C. It's what we used to call the reestablishment of a non-conforming use or structure. Have that process still in place, which means even today, if we had an existing single-wide mobile home, someone wanted to replace it with like-kind, they could go through that public hearing process to reestablish that use and that structure as long as it was there legally. So that process is still available. Because of that process already in place, because of how other communities deal with this kind of situation, and our general language about the intent of non-conforming uses, which is to phase them out over time, staff is recommending denial of these proposed amendments. I'd answer any questions you might have.
Commissioners, any questions for staff?
Just one comment. It seemed like we were backing up doing this. We've been doing this, trying to get cut down on this cleaning by homes and non-conforming uses. Glad y'all recommended denial.
Any other questions for staff?
I will open this up to the audience. Anybody here this evening wishing to speak for this text amendment change? Anyone here wishing to speak for this text amendment change? There being none, is anyone here this evening wishing to speak against this text amendment change? Anyone wishing to speak against the text amendment change? There being none, commissioners, any discussion on this text amendment change? If not, I'll take a motion on this.
Mr. Chairman.
Commissioner Hall.
I recommend that we, on VA 2017-117, the text amendment change, we recommend denial to the city council.
Have a motion from Commissioner Hall. Any discussion on the motion before?
Second.
Got a second from Commissioner Folsom. We have a motion and a second. All in favor, please signify by raising your right hand. All against, please signify by raising your right hand. All abstaining, please signify by raising your right hand. Ms. Carmella, that is 5-1 for tonight. Ma'am, thank you so much for your input this evening. Jason, we'll move on to the county cases now.